Hey everyone, I hope you had a great day. Today we are looking at some new malicious compliance stories. I hope you enjoy them. The first story is called You Want an Effective HOA? I live in a small subdivision that has an HOA. The HOA is still run by the developer and the management is outsourced to a third-party company. So, no head of the HOA Karen that lives in the neighborhood, constantly monitoring everything. We do, however, have a private Facebook neighborhood group. My neighbor is a complainer. He always complains about the ineffective HOA because people have installed sheds and above-ground pools. While these things are discouraged, they are allowed with ARC approval. Basically, email the management company a modification request with the specs and pictures and they approve it. So all the stuff he is complaining about has more than likely been approved by the HOA management company. I don't think my neighbor is aware of this because he complains about it every few months like clockwork. So earlier this month, I noticed my neighbor and a few other houses in the neighborhood had put out political yard signs in their yards. According to the HOA covenants, this is prohibited and there is no approval process. It's just not allowed. So I emailed the guy at the management company that handles our HOA to let him know. He emailed everyone that day to remind them that yard signs are prohibited and gave everyone 7 days to remove them before they get a violation. My neighbor posted last week about receiving a violation in the mail. He was angry. But hey, he wanted an effective HOA, right? The next story is called Only with Invitation. This happened a couple of years ago. My boss wanted me to attend a conference in another city and that I am to attend everything. I looked at the agenda and there was an additional meeting associated with the conference that looked like I didn't need to attend. When I tried to ask her about it, she cut me off and said, "Everything." So I went to the meeting. I got a lot of side-eyed looks, was asked why I was there at one point, to which my reply was, "My boss told me to attend." They know my boss. I ran into my boss the next day at the conference. She asked if I attended the meeting. I told her I did and would be happy to report what I learned. She just said, "Not good," turned her back to me and started talking with someone else. Back at work the following week, she called me in for a meeting to tell me I should not have attended that meeting. And in the future, I will only attend meetings that I am specifically invited to. Again, she cut me off when I tried to explain. A couple of days later, our department was having an important meeting and an Outlook meeting notice went out to everyone, but not me. I worked away as all of my coworkers shuffle off to the meeting and then back again at the conclusion of the meeting. My boss comes to my cubicle, angry. "Why weren't you at the meeting?" It was hard not to smile when I told her that I was not invited. Her face turned red and she stammered, "That was an oversight." I just shrugged my shoulders and told her I was just respecting her directions. She stormed off. Amazingly, I still work there, but she has improved her communication a little bit. The third story is called Please Leave. A few years ago, I was stuck in a bad, albeit well-paid job. I was in middle management and hated it. My boss was an idiot who, while on a personal level was nice, as a boss was a horrible fit. So after working here, I got an amazing opportunity at another firm doing what I wanted to do. I walk into my boss's office and hand in my 2 weeks notice. He looks down and says, "Thanks, no need to stay, please get your things and leave." I was kinda shocked because I still had work that was complicated and important to the firm, albeit not something that he couldn't do himself. So I asked him to confirm that he wants me out and that as of this minute I don't work for the company, so he's firing me. He said yes, I'm not needed, and so I can leave immediately. So I calmly said, "Okay, great, can you please put that in writing so that I have a record that I'm being fired since you don't need me, so I can file for unemployment." Immediately, you can see the blood leave his face and the realization of what his decision would do and stammers out a, "What? Why? Why would you do that?" I say, "Well, I wanted to give 2 weeks so I can finish up my projects and hand them off." I was expecting that income, and if I'm fired, I won't get it, and because it's courtesy to provide a 2-week notice. Since you are firing me, I won't get paid, and the unemployment will replace a portion of my lost income. He says, stay here please, I'll be right back, and speed walks out of his office to presumably HR. I'm sitting there for about 20 minutes, and my coworkers who sit right outside his office are cracking up. When he comes back, he says that I'm not being fired, but that today was my last day, and that I'll be paid for the 2 weeks. So for my last 2 weeks, I was able to get paid, go to happy hours and relax, all because I maliciously complied for 20 minutes. I hope you enjoyed today's video so far. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to press the like button, it really helps. And now, onto the last story. The last story is called Bad Professor. This happened during my engineering course. I've had this teacher for math in second year. She was kind of a jerk. Blowing small things out of proportion, screaming at anyone who did a mistake, just wanting to make life harder for anyone she despised. That kind. We were pretty much used to her, so we generally laid low on her radar. But this changed when she was appointed as the first year coordinator. She started coming late for classes, and any instance of misbehavior, she would skip what needed to be taught in that class and leave. This was a bad thing, since I didn't even know what I didn't even know, and math was generally hard at this point. Now, the tests were coming up, so she gave us some problems and a bunch of reference material and problems that should have been taught in class. She asked us to solve and submit them, so she can review and correct them in case of any mistake. We scrambled and hustled, finally finishing them on time. We waited, waited, but we never got those books back. Previous to the day for the test, I go to her and ask for my book. She has completely forgotten about it, starts panicking, and when I offer to come again later, she stops me. She says that since she was so busy with her new duties, she couldn't correct them. And seeing that I'm free, I needed to go through them, as it will be like a revision for the test. I'm irked. I'm not exactly free, as I had a class coming up, but she's not ready to listen to anything and hurries off elsewhere. Having no choice, I start correcting it. It takes around an hour and 15 minutes just to finish one book. She comes back, sighs, and asks me to not be lethargic and pick up speed and goes away again. Cue malicious compliance. I start ticking everything, wrong problems, incomplete problems, blank pages. I don't care. So after around 20 minutes, I finished everyone's book and I go to look for her. Since this part of the campus is relatively small, I look for her in the small possibility of places she might have been. And I find her in the cafeteria, chatting with other professors, drinking coffee, having a great time. She sees me and comes along, telling me that she was in a meeting, but she is free now, and asks whether the work is done. She tells me to go back and wait for her as she will come in 2 minutes. All the guilt of doing bad work or no work vanished by this point, and I waited for her in her cabin, where she comes back after 10 minutes. She puts her signature on the corrected books and tells me that it's my responsibility that it will be delivered to the owners. No thank you, nothing, just more work. I begrudgingly give them back to everyone, and by now I had lost around 3 to 4 hours and hurriedly prepare for the test. By this point, I haven't had thought of the implications of what I had done, because I just wanted to get out of doing her work for her. Then, when the results were shared, 73% of the people had failed the test. Her cabin was stormed with pretty much everyone who insisted that they had done exactly what they did in that book, which she corrected, but still didn't get any marks. She sees me standing by the door and calls me out.
You! The one in the blue shirt! Come here, at once!
She doesn't even know my name and used such a bad way of identifying me. I'm angry and I slip away, since there were many students wearing a blue shirt. This ensured more chaos, as she claimed it was that person's fault, not hers, and led to a couple of shouting matches between her and the students. Finally, the management gets involved in this and they started reviewing what she had done. It turns out, she was giving many of her duties as a professor to other students. updating attendants, marks, who had come to her cabin asking for help. They were mad. She was demoted to her former post and was suspended without pay for 6 weeks. She was angry and lashed out at the board members on social media, giving wild accusations against them. She deleted her post when they informed her that if she gets another complaint against her, she will be demoted even further. But sadly, as it was the middle of the year, the professor couldn't be replaced and she continued teaching my class. I tried to wear a blue shirt whenever I had her class, just so she would be constantly reminded of what I did to her. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like. And if you want to see more videos, don't forget to subscribe. Have a great day and stay safe. Bye-bye.